Hello students, today now we are here to discuss circuit breaker part 2. Now firstly, oil circuit breakers. Now mineral oil has better insulating properties than air, but it has also some disadvantages. It is inflammable, it may cause high fire hazards. There is possibility of its forming an explosive mixture with air. Because of the production of carbon particles in the oil due to heating, reconditioning or replacement is required. So now, till now, oil circuit breaker has been developed in these categories: plain break oil circuit breaker, controlled break oil circuit breaker, minimum oil circuit breaker. Now we'll discuss them one by one. Now plain break oil circuit breaker. This circuit breaker consists of a metal tank which has oil in it and it has two or more contacts. Since large energies are dissipated within the tank, a large gaseous pressure is developed. To withstand such a pressure, the tank has to be strong. An air cushion is necessary between the oil surface and the tank cover to accommodate the displaced oil when the gas is formed around the arc. This air cushion also absorbs the mechanical shock of the upward oil movement, which is displaced due to the formation of arc. Now, what is the principle of operation of this plain break oil circuit breaker? It involves the simple process of separating the current carrying contacts under oil with no special control over the resulting arc over the other than increase in the length caused by the moving contact. Means there is a fixed contact and there is a moving contact. Now moving contact will move and therefore the arc is increased in its length and then the final arc extension is obtained. At the instant of contact separation, an arc is established. The separation is very small, so again a high voltage gradient as we have discussed in the earlier lecture. Now the gas obtained from the oil is mainly hydrogen and it is dissipated in its atomic form, releasing lots of energy. So the arc attains a temperature of 5000 Kelvin. The mixture of gases occupies a volume about 1000 times that of the oil decomposed. So oil is pushed away from the arc, and based on energy balance principle which we have discussed in previous lecture, final arc extension takes place at current zero. Now minimum oil circuit breaker. Minimum oil circuit breaker, we have to consider them in some design development, that is oil is only maintained for arc quenching. So there is reduction in tank size, reduction in total weight and reduction in cost. They can be of self blast type or external blast type or combination of two. In the case of self blast type, the gas pressure developed depends upon the current to be interrupted. The higher the current, the larger will be the gas pressure and more effective is the breaker for arc quenching. Now air blast circuit breakers. Arc interruption properties of hydrogen, which is formed in oil circuit breaker, they are much superior to air. But now these oil circuit breaker have some disadvantages, that is they cause fire hazards, they form explosive mixture with air. So now air circuit breakers are used. In the case of air circuit breakers, the arc is extinguished by lengthening and increasing the voltage gradient. The arc discharge is moved upward by both thermal and electromagnetic effects. This is then driven into chutes, which is consisting of splitters and baffles. In splitters, the length of the arc is lengthened and it is effective in cooling of the arc. Now the fixed and the moving contacts are held in the case of air blast circuit breakers, the fixed and moving contact are held in close position by the spring pressure. The breaker reservoir is connected to the arc chamber when the tripping impulse opens the air valves. The air entering the air chamber exerts pressure on the moving contact, which moves, and the air moves with the sonic velocity near the nozzle, and the arc is subjected to high pressure and there is considerable heat due to forced convection. So now in the case of air blast circuit breakers, the quenching is forced convection principle based. Now vacuum circuit breakers. Firstly, we'll discuss what is a vacuum system. Vacuum system is one in which pressure is maintained at a value below the atmospheric pressure and it is measured in terms of mm of mercury. Now in vacuum arc, The neutral atoms, ions and electrons do not come from the medium in which arc is drawn, but they are obtained from the electrodes by evaporating its surface material. This is the main point in vacuum circuit breaker. Because of the large mean free path for the electrons, the dielectric strength of the vacuum is 1,000 times more than when the gas is used as an interrupting medium. So nowadays, vacuum circuit breakers are widely used. Now the vacuum arc consists results from neutral atoms, ions and electrons which are emitted from the electrodes. As the current carrying contacts are separated, cathode spots are formed. For low currents, highly mobile cathode spots are formed, and for large currents, a multiple number of cathode spots are formed. Now these spots is the main source of electrons. The process involved in drying the arc will be due to high electric field between the contacts. The cathode surfaces normally are not perfectly smooth, but they have micro projections. When the arc interruption is over, the space between the surrounding the electrons is filled with vapor and plasma. The presence of this residue affects very much the ability of the interrupter to withstand high voltages. So the process by which residue decays and by which the vacuum regains its dielectric strength is known as arc recovery phenomenon.